Hi everyone, my name is Raindrops. If you're new, welcome. And if you're already one of my drops, you guys know how I feel about you. Hey. Today's video, hair video. I am, so by the title, I'm going to do a wash and go on dry hair. I already washed it. I conditioned it. I do not deep condition. So you're not gonna hear me say, oh, I deep conditioned my hair freshly. No, I washed it, I conditioned it, that's it. I didn't oil my scalp because what I'm using has plenty of it in it. So I just braided it up because I wanted it to be in a stretch state and I wanted it to dry. So last week I did a wash and go on my hair and I wanted to see how this would turn out. And I will insert a picture here because it came out very cute. And it's not oily like most of the others I've tried before, Edge Control, and I did not see a video on it. I only saw one, but I did my hair before I saw the video yesterday. I don't know her name of her channel, but she had a taper cut and she used Curls Blueberry Paste, which I had used in the past, just on my edges, never throughout my hair. But it's oily as shit. It just smells really, really wonderful, but it's really oily. It did not lay my edges down, it curled it up. I tried the Palmer's Olive Oil Edge Control, same thing, and also the Shine Edge Control. So I found this and I love it to death, so I wanted to try it and see. When you apply it, it feels wet and sticky. I want to do another afro, but I want a lot of curly texture in it. When I did my wash and go a couple of videos before this, I used the Eco Style Gold Gel, and I used the Daily Moisturizer from TGIN. So it flakes. So I just washed it out the next day, and then I did a protective style. So took the protective style out. I want to wear my hair. So yeah, if you want to see how this is dry, wash and go using this one product, the Murray's Edge Control. Stay tuned. Okay, really quick, I'm finished, almost finished this section of my hair, and as you can see, when I started, they looked straight like they weren't going to do anything, but your hair does, you know, curl back up. And look at all of that shine, guys. Like, look at all of that definition. So this is curling up as I'm doing, you know, each section of hair. So don't worry if you have some straight pieces. Unless you already have some type of heat damage or bleach damage to your hair, then it probably won't curl, but I don't have any damage. As you can see, it's curling up. It's just the weight of the beeswax. So yeah, let's keep going. finished half of my head. I'm gonna do the other half off camera. And this is how it's looking. This will, like I said, curl up. It's full of shine. It's full of hold. It's not like that's the oil. So I didn't need to apply any oil, any gel for hold or any of that. So I'll come back when both sides are done and then show you the finished look at the end. Okay guys, really quick. As you can see, they have really curled up and they're still in the process of curling up even more. Just this section here, but it is still a little, I guess you could say damp. So I'm going to let it finish air drying, because so far it's been about 25 minutes. So the way that it feels like in the roots, I probably have like another 20 minutes to go. And I don't want to blow dry, so I'm just letting it air dry so I can pick it out. And yeah, so the next time you see, I should have my afro, I guess, in full effect, and hopefully it sets like I want it to. But yeah, these are the results of just the edge control. It's really soft. And I like the definition of my curls as well.